So, good afternoon. Second year BCom, Computer Applications, Semester 4. Second year BCom, Computer Applications, Semester 4, Web Technologies, Unit 2. Unit 2 is DHTML. So, we know that DHTML is a combination of 5 to 6 technologies. First one is style sheets or cache carding style sheets or CSS that we discussed in the last class. Second one is JavaScript. Third one is DOM or document object model. Fourth one is events or event handling or event programming. Fifth one is placing text and graphics. So today we discuss about JavaScript, basics of JavaScript. Unit 3 contains a total, unit 3 is allotted to JavaScript. Total unit 3 is allotted to programming in JavaScript. So today we discuss about JavaScript slides. So we start with some slides about JavaScript programming, like that. So in this PPT we may discuss about what is overview of JavaScript, how does JavaScript work in a browser, basic JavaScript syntax and examples of JavaScript. So what are the features and applications of JavaScript, and how JavaScript is working, and syntax of JavaScript, various syntax features and applications of JavaScript, various features and applications of basic syntax of JavaScript, and examples and example programs, various program statements of JavaScript, and what is the difference between Java and JavaScript. All these things we are going to discuss here. So what is JavaScript and what are its features and applications? JavaScript was designed to add interactivity, so HTML pages. So JavaScript is mainly, what is the difference between Java and JavaScript is, Java is it is an application program, application software. Whereas JavaScript is used with web applications or websites, or with any websites or web pages like this. So JavaScript is mainly used along with HTML pages. Similarly, JavaScript code, it is called as JavaScript code, is embedded or inserted into HTML pages. JavaScript is a scripting language. A scripting language is a lightweight programming language. So, mainly JavaScript is a scripting language. Basically, there are two types of scripting languages are used. First one is JavaScript, and second one is VBScript. JavaScript is one of the scripting languages. There are many other scripting languages are used, but JavaScript is a client-side scripting language. JavaScript is a client-side end-user scripting language, whereas VBScript is a server-side scripting language used at servers, whereas JavaScript is client-side, mainly used for client systems and client devices like mobiles and others, mainly used for validating data forms and validating program data entry like that. The JavaScript contains of lines of executable computer code. So generally, the JavaScript contains or consists of lines of executable computer code, means it is a interpreted code. JavaScript is mainly, it contains all the interpreted code, which is simply inserted in between HTML language. The JavaScript is usually embedded directly into HTML pages. So generally, JavaScript is mainly used to insert or embed into HTML code, any part of the HTML code or anywhere in the HTML code. So we simply insert or embed a JavaScript code into HTML pages wherever we want. And JavaScript is an interpreted language, means that scripts execute without preliminary compilation. So another feature of JavaScript is, there is no special software required, or there is no compiler interpreter required to run JavaScript code or applications in any web browser or in any websites. So JavaScript is an interpreted language, means that scripts are directly executed without preliminary compilation, means there is no special software required to run the JavaScript. Everyone can use JavaScript without purchasing a license. Why? Because JavaScript is a free version, and we can use without any license. And JavaScript supports all the operating systems, all the browsers, and all the systems, and all the hardware and software environments, all type of, any type of browsers, any type of operating systems versions. So you can use and run and use JavaScript programs on any type of, any on any environment, any hardware environment, software operating systems like that. So what is the difference between JavaScript and Java? So by now you should have realized that you already known as a great deal of JavaScript. So far we have talked about things that are the same as in Java. JavaScript has some features that reassemble features in Java. So JavaScript also some features, common features with Java code or Java language. JavaScript has object and primitive data types. So mainly JavaScript has some features that common with Java. So JavaScript has objects and primitive data types. JavaScript has qualified names, for example, document.write hello world. JavaScript has events and event handlers. Exception handling in JavaScript is almost the same as in Java. JavaScript has some features unlike anything Java. So variable names are untyped. Objects and arrays are defined in quite a different way. JavaScript has with statements and a new kind of for statement. So all these are the common properties and similarities in between JavaScript and Java. So why we use JavaScript? Means to add dynamic function to your HTML. JavaScript does not thinks that HTML can't like logic. You can change HTML on the fly to shoulder some of the form processing buttons. So JavaScript runs the browser, not on the web server. Better performance. And JavaScript can validate the data that users enter into the form before it's sent to your web application. So dynamic positioning or dynamic handling of the websites or dynamic programming of the websites, and JavaScript does things that HTML can't like logic. You can change HTML on the fly, and JavaScript runs on the browser. So JavaScript generally runs on any browser, any type of browser, any type of operating system, browser and versions, not on web servers. So, and best performance, better performance compared to Java. So generally JavaScript is used to validation purpose only. Generally JavaScript is used to data validation purposes only. JavaScript is used. Next, when not to use JavaScript means when you need to access other resources, means files, programs and databases. When you are using sensitive or copyrighted data or algorithms, your JavaScript code is opening to the public. So in these cases JavaScript is generally not used. And how to add JavaScript code to your HTML. So how to add JavaScript code to your HTML. In the HTML page itself, so generally we may write HTML head script. So to embed or to insert. To insert or to embed JavaScript code. To insert or to embed JavaScript code in your HTML code, JavaScript code or JavaScript program in your HTML code, we may simply use script tag. script tag. So how to use script tag? Script slash script. How to add a script tag or how to use JavaScript into the HTML page or HTML code means script, by using script and slash script code. So the syntax is simple. Script language is equals to script language is equals to within quotes JavaScript, and two slashes means JavaScript remarks, JavaScript code remarks, and slash script. Generally JavaScript code is written in between script and slash script code, and it is written anywhere in the HTML code, means before the head and inside the header section, inside the body section, after the body section, anywhere in the HTML code, and as a file linked from the HTML code. So similarly, you can directly, there are two ways to use JavaScript code in HTML. First one is by writing directly, or by simply inserting, or by writing inserting JavaScript code in with the help of script slash script, and by linking a file as a file linked from the HTML page. So by using script tag only, we can directly load or select the JavaScript file. So script language is equals to within quotes JavaScript, src is equals to within quotes script.js. So the syntax is simple. Script language is equals to JavaScript, src is equal to within quotes script.js. .js means it is a JavaScript file or JavaScript code. So we may simply call any JavaScript code by using the script syntax like this. Script language is equals to JavaScript, src is equal to script dot some script file name dot js. So these are the two ways or two methods to use or to insert JavaScript in a HTML page. So what are the different parts, what are the different components of HTML page? What are the different elements, or what are the different components of HTML JavaScript code? So first of all, it is variables. Second one is arrays. Third one is functions. So first one is called as variables. Second one is called as arrays. Third one is called as functions. So these are the three important components or elements of a JavaScript. So we discuss one by one. Primitive data types are data types. So what are the different types of data types available in JavaScript? What are the popular data types available in JavaScript? So JavaScript has three primitive. Primitive means primary data types. Primitive data types means primary data types. So JavaScript has three primitive types: number, string, and boolean. JavaScript has three primitive types: number, string, and boolean. So everything else is an object. So remaining except these number, string, and boolean, others are treated as objects. What is an object? Object is generally, it is a part of a HTML code or anything else. Generally objects have some properties and some methods like that. Numbers are always stored as floating point values. So generally in JavaScript, the numbers are stored in a floating point numbers or a decimal notation values, not in integer values. Hexadecimal numbers begins with OX. So similarly, some platforms that similarly strings may be enclosed in single quotes or double quotes. So for using and representing strings, we may use single quotes or double quotes. Strings can contain a slash and slash, double quote, etc. Booleans are either true or false. So boolean is also one of the data type. Generally boolean is also one of the data type available in JavaScript. It is used to store either a true or a false value, or yes or no values like that. So these are the primitive data types. What are primitive data types? Number, to store any type of numbers. String, to store any type of strings in double quotes or single quotes. And boolean. Boolean means generally it is used to store or assign either true or false, or yes or no type of data. All the remaining data types are treated as objects. Everything is treated as an object. So variables. So variables, what is a variable? We know that variable is generally used to change its value. Variables are used to change its value during program execution. So how to use variables in JavaScript? So the syntax of writing JavaScript program is script, language is equal to JavaScript, and we may use some common symbols, less than, question mark, dash dash, definition of variables, where num char is equal to 25, semicolon, where passenger per char is equal to 3, calculation of total number of people. So this is some simple example. Alert is a function. Alert is a JavaScript function to display some message or to display some variable. So this is a simple JavaScript program. So variables, JavaScript has untyped variables. Typed and untyped means, typed means specific to a particular data type. Specific to particular data type are called as typed data types. Untyped means using of any storing of any data type in any variable. So variables are declared with the var keyword. So how to declare variables in how to declare and use variables in JavaScript? By using var keyword, by using var, var keyword. So the syntax is var num is equals to within quotes 1 semicolon, var name is equals to within quotes nil semicolon, var some phone number is equals to within quotes something. So variables are declared with a var statement. Generally in JavaScript, variables are declared and defined by using var keyword. So syntax is where pi is equals to 3.1416 comma x comma y comma name is equals to within quotes dotted div. Variable names must begin with a letter or underscore. Variable names are case sensitive. Means why? Because case sensitive means we know that JavaScript is a case sensitive scripting language. Means only lowercase letters are used in JavaScript. Variables are generally untyped. They can hold values of any type. Untyped means every variable is used to or capable to store any type of data or information in JavaScript. So variables are untyped. They can hold values of any type. Untyped means every variable is used to store any type of data. Means, for example, if you define a variable x comma y as var, means both these x comma y are capable to store any type of data. Means numeric, string, character, boolean, and integers, float, real, etc. So the word var is optional, but it's a good style to use it. Variables declared within a function are local to that function, accessible only within that function. So variables defined and declared within a function are called as local variables. Similarly, variables declared outside a function are called as global functions. Means accessible from anywhere on the page. Generally, the variables declared and defined outside the functions are called as global functions, and global variables and global functions are accessible from anywhere within the program. So next, operators in JavaScript. So what are the different types of operators used in JavaScript? So because most JavaScript syntax is borrowed from C and is therefore just like Java, we won't spend much time on it. So the operators in JavaScript are almost same as in C, C++, Java. So arithmetic operators are plus, minus, star, slash, percentage, plus plus and minus minus. We know that plus plus and minus minus are increment and decrement operators. Comparison operators are relational operators, are less than or equals to, double equals to, not equals to, greater than or equals to, greater than. And logical operators are AND, OR, NOT. Same as C, C++, Java. Bitwise operators are AND, vertical bar, and caret symbol, tiled, double left shift, right shift, triple shift. Assignment operators are plus is equals to, minus is equals to, star is equals to, slash is equals to, percentage is equals to, less than equals to, like that. So next operators one and operators two. String concatenation operator. String operator or string concatenation operator is plus, means is used to join two or more strings. Conditional operator. Conditional operator is also same as in C, C++. So comments. How to write comments in JavaScript program? So comments are as in C or Java, between slash slash and the end of the line, between slash star and star slash statements. So what are statements? Most JavaScript statements are also borrowed from C. So JavaScript statements are almost same in syntax as in C language, C or C++ or Java. So assignment operator means equals to. Compound statement means brackets. If statement is also same,